Dear student, today we will discuss the concept of backup, recovery, concept of attach, how to attach the different sample schema in SQL Server. When we say that we are having the database, we have to take the backup of the any database of SQL Server. The extension for the backup file, that is .bak. So whenever we are taking the backup, if anything happened with that one database, we have to recover database. For that one, we are having the different recovery approaches are there. If we want to move the data from one database to another database, at the time of the creation of the database, we are creating two main file. First file is that the name of that one file, two file. At the time of these are two by default file are creating, even we can create it, or even if we are writing simple command create database name of database, so it create the database two files in SQL Server, two files at SQL Server database. First one we are having the extension of that one file is .mdf, that is a master data file, and second one is file is here we are having the ldf .ldf, and this one is called the log data file, transaction log data files. Master data file, this one file is also called the primary data file or master data file. Second file we have a log data file. These are the two basic files whenever we are creating the database. If we want to move data from one database to another database, we are having the concept of MDF file. Using those MDF and LDF file, we may be able to move the data from one location to another location, one server to another server. So for that one, if we are having .mdf file, then for that one we have a concept of attach. If we are having the backup file .bak, then we have to go for the recovery technique or database recovery approach. We have to use it. How we can use it? Let's see. In SQL Server, let me start the SSMS SQL Server Management Studio 2017 IF. So first we have to connect, login. These are the files user can create these file at its his or her desired location, or even this file can be created on the default location. The default location for the backup file in MDF and LDF file, that is in the C drive we are having the, in C drive we have a program file SQL Server. MS SQL, and then we are having the data is available. So in data, what are the different databases are there? All of those databases log files are available as well as data files are available. Like I have Adventure Work 2017. This one is a file type. If we check the file type of this one, so we have a file type that is a primary data file, and this one is Adventure Work 2017 log. This one is a log data file. So automatically two different files are created. Even we can create these log file of our own desired locations, or that can be created on these default locations. So similarly, if we see that we have, where is the backup file, so in MS SQL we are having another folder, that is the backup folder is there. Whenever we are having the backup, we can create backup of our own desired location, or we can place it over here on this one location. Let me remove it. This one is Adventure Work 2017. Is a simple schema. We will create it over here in today lecture. Again, let me start the SSMS. So SQL Server Management Studio, we have to select the window authentication or SQL Server authentication. If SQL Server authentication, we have to enter the username and password. For window authentication, no need to enter the username and password, that is already authenticated. Now here we have to enter user server name. As you already know, our system name will be considered as a server names, and we have to select the database engine. So server name is here, given is here, database engine. Now we have to click it over here on connect. It will connect to the database engine, that is desktop ENBCS5V. It will connect it with the database as large volume of the data is available and different databases are available, that's why it is taking time. So first we will create the database, and then on that one database we will check these master file and log data files in the data folder. Then we have to remove them, and then we have to take the backup of the database, and then check the backup file. Then we will go for the recovery, and at the end we will attach the file with the database. Now you can see here window authentication, in server name is here, then that no, this one name is my PC name and database engine. Now authentication process is done. Here we have our database, click it over here, expand it. Different databases are available. Let we are having database airline reservation systems. If we want to remove this one database, how we can remove it or drop it, we have the two different methods. Click on the new query and simply write it over here, the database. Okay, first we have to create the database and then check master data file there, log data file. How we can create a database? Simply either we have to click here, create database, new database, or we can simply click it over here, create database, name of database, we say BSC7 is the database name, execute it, so our database will be created. Now if we want to move to the new database, then we have to go use it over here, the use BSC7 and go, we will move to the BSC7 database. After this one we can add the create the table, create table, name of table std, we are having column is here id, data type of this one is int, and this one is the primary key. Next one is a name, and data type of this one is a varchar. Size of this one is at 20 and execute it. Now one table is created. Here we create one table BSC7. So if that is not shown, right click it over here and refresh it. We will find the BSC7 table Here BSE7 table is here, expanded table is here. We will have one table with the name of STD. Here one table is available, still no data is there. Now let's see that when we create the one table database BSE7, so there must be BSE7 with the name of BSE, MDF and LDF file must be created in data folder. Let's see how. In the data folder we have a BSE7 one file is here, this one is a primary data file, BSE7 log, this one is a log transaction log data file. Now let me we have to change the move to the other database like remove the extensions. Now I'm using the use airline reservations, so execute it. Now let we are taking the backup of this one database. What should be the how we may be able to take the backups of the database? So backup of the BSE7, just right click it over here, task, and then click on backup. In this way we may be able to take the backup of the database. Where we have to take the backup, we can just, we are having the different full backup, we have to take different type of the database are there. So with database BSE7, so full backup we want to use it over a differential or transaction log. We will discuss these things later on. At this stage just we are taking the backup. Now which location we can mention any location over here. Just by default location I am taking the backup BSE7.back. So click it over here, add. So it will create the backup. If you want to change the location, click it over here. You can assign mention any location and any size of this one. So if you don't want to make the change, as it is, this one is okay. Okay, and then click on OK button. Our it will display that our database backup completed successfully. Okay, now backup of this one is done. Where we created backup is created in the we are having one folder is here. The name of folder is backup, and this one folder BSE7.back file is available. This one is a backup file. Let me drop the database from here, or we can drop the database. Simply, we have to write the query, drop database name of database, or simply we have to right click over here and then click on delete buttons. Any both of these options can be used to drop a database. So we can write drop database name of database, or we can simply right click and delete options. So any one of these we can may be able to use for to drop the database, and then we will recover using the restore the database using from the backup file. Okay, let me write the query over here. Drop database name of database BSE7 and execute it. Oh no, we don't need to enter the new query, just write drop database name of database BSE7 and execute it. Command completed successfully. If we checked it over here, our BSE7 database will no longer here, we already remove it. Check it out, refresh it. We don't have the database with the name of BSE7. Now what we have to do, we want to restore it. How we can restore it? With the right click on database and then click on the restore database. So where the location there where we are having the database is there. So on the device we have a database, and click over here on the bubble button, add location of this database we have a, that is BSE7B. Click it over here and click OK. Now it will select its file, the backup files. Progress is done. Then it says that type of backup is full, server is there, database is there, and what is the position of this one, and click on OK button. Now it will take the full backup of the database and display the message that database restored successfully. Click on OK button. Now what the database was there, that is fully restored. Right click and click on table. We have one table over there previously, and that will be restored over here. This one is here. Now this one is how to restore the database. Now if we are having the database, any simple database on the internet, we have to use that one, and we have to start working on that one. How we may be able to attach or restore those databases? Let we are having one database is here, Adventure Work. How we can do it? Just click it over here. Let me download it from internet. Although I already have, just I want to show Adventure Work database. Adventure Work database. So latest version of Adventure Work, that is the 2019 or 2017, that can be there. So we have to find, select any one of them. Okay, and now in the Microsoft, how we can do it, click on this one website on the Microsoft. That is a simple database containing the different tables are there, large volume of the data is there, and data is available. So now is there any Adventure Work databases available? No. Okay, here we have a I am taking it over Adventure Work 2019.back. Right click it over here, and now it says that save files. Okay, so it will take little times. Now approximately 2 minutes. Now although I already have the file is here, Adventure Work with the name of 2017, that is available over here in the download, Adventure Work 2017 file is dot backup file is there. Let me copy it, and then we have to paste this on files in the backup folders. Now move to the C drive. We have a program file, and the program file we have a Microsoft SQL Server. In SQL Server we have this one folder, then MS SQL. Next one is a backup. Right click and paste. Now backup is we bring the backup in backup folder. Next step as I think so. This that is taking time. I'm removing it. Write it. I already have this one attached, although I am removing it over here from. So right click and delete. So it will remove everything related to the SQL Server. Click it over here. Okay. It will remove the SQL Server Adventure Work database. Now that is removed. Now again, I want to restore it. Right click and restore. As we don't have the MDF file, if we have any MDF file, we can use the concept of attach simply. Device, click it over here, add, and we have the file that is Adventure Work 2017.bk. Now this one file is here, click it over here on OK button. Now that is also a full backup. Click on OK button. %35, that's done. Click on OK button. Now database is Adventure Work 2017 is attached over here or restored over here. Now if you want to check, right click, table. We are having so many tables are available in the Adventure Work database. If you check here, we have a table is here like department. Right click and top 200 rows. It will display the these rows are here. Different rows are available, in the department table. Same for all the other table. So this one is a simple schema table. So that is used to retrieve the data. Now, this one is related to the backup and recovery of the data and how to attach the sample database. Thanks for watching the video.